So when you're talking tablets, I think one of the biggest areas that you got to focus on is the multimedia aspect. And the reason I say that is because, you know, if you're the type of person that's got, you know, work that you do from home on a regular basis and you need to, you know, get in Excel or get in Microsoft Word and really bang out, you know, some memos or crunch numbers or whatever it is that you do, chances are you're not going to be doing that on a tablet. You're probably going to get your laptop out and get to work. But where tablets have the ability to shine to me is, you know, that kickback on the couch factor where you're just, you know, lounging and you want to surf the web or watch videos or, you know, play some games. And that to me is, you know, an important factor. So in that department, I do think the Xoom has a lot to offer. You know, you got the HD video recording. Of course, you got the full HTML web browser. The media player has been reworked quite a bit. Let's go ahead and pull that up. And let's rotate it. And you see, now you get kind of this wall of music. And all this stuff is came preloaded, which was different. I haven't seen that on an Android device yet to have this much music already included. But I'm about to go ahead and play a joint. This is by Saigon. There we go. You can see it looks a lot different than the old Android player. So there we go, man. That's just to give you guys a taste of the media player. But it's a real cool experience, man. I just, you know, I like the whole look, the wall of album art that you can, you know, just scroll and browse through. Big time upgrade over the old stock media player, which had been in need of, you know, an upgrade for a long time now. And watching, you know, movies and watching video is just as enjoyable. Just all around very solid media player. So big props to Google for getting that figured out. Another cool feature is I mentioned you got HD video. Over here you got the little movie studio app, which actually allows you to edit video. And so you see here I can click and I can shorten a clip just like that. I can, stretch it back out to its entirety. You see here I can hit play and preview it. And then up here you've got different options. I can, if I press on the clip and hold, now you see I got the option. I can do different transitions if I want to do that. Let me back out. Or if I wanted to add a subtitle, I can actually do that. And it actually works real well. I got a separate video I'm gonna post up and just show you guys just a quick, you know, 10-second video with a subtitle added and a real simple fade to black. But it actually works, you know, real well and works pretty nice. And so I thought that was a cool feature. The camera on here ain't gonna blow you away. I've gotten some pretty decent photos, and a lot of it depends on the lighting. In good lighting scenarios, you know, photos have actually turned out pretty well. But on, you know, in certain scenarios, pictures can look a little bit kind of dark and kind of grainy. But, you know, nonetheless, it's a tablet, so you're probably not going to be using this to, you know, take a ton of photos. So, you know, it's not too big of a complaint. Now let's fire up the web browser. And this is something that I'm going to go ahead and let's see. Just let me back out. Let me go to Detroit News real quick. We'll go to the Wolverines page. Shouts to my Wolverines for making the tournament. We're about to go ahead and knock off Tennessee, hopefully. And we'll see if we can get this to pull up. And you guys may get a chance to see the issue that I've been having with Wi-Fi, which if you look down here, it says I've got showing two bars on the Wi-Fi connection. which definitely isn't the best, but it should be, should definitely be loading quicker than this. This is an issue. Yeah, there it goes. Decided it wanted to move. So here's the Detroit news page. But the other day, shouts to Droid Life, the Adobe Flash plugin, or the update for to allow Adobe Flash, was actually pushed out from Verizon, and then Droid Life and a few of the other Android blogs actually got their hands on the actual Flash player for Honeycomb, and it actually works pretty well. And if this page would ever finish rendering, I was gonna show you guys some embedded Flash video. And don't let this be an indictment on the tablet itself. It hasn't, you know, always performed, you know, this sluggish, and I'm not sure if it's just the website right now or if it's just that Wi-Fi connection or what. But of course, you got your pinch to zoom support that works nicely. I think we got there should be a video right here, which I was gonna try to play, but unfortunately that's not looking like it's gonna load up right now. I'll jump on over to my site real fast. We'll see if that'll actually render any quicker. Hold on, we're getting super sluggish response, so let me go ahead and this kind of shows you guys how you get to the settings. That's a little bit different as well if you were used to old school Android. And jump out of there, and we will go back to our browser. So now that I'm here, I can go back to my bookmarks, and actually let's go ahead and pull up, let's do ESPN instead. We might be able to get some Flash video. You can see the 3G is on and popping. That actually took off real quick. And of course you got all the March Madness stuff right now, but everything looks, you know, real good. This has been a real fun device to kick back with in the evenings and, you know, just do your browsing and web surfing with. And I'm going to go ahead and jump out of this. And let me go ahead and open up the YouTube app, which is another app that has been customized for this device. And I actually like it a lot. And you got the same kind of thing that you had going on with the media player. You get kind of this wall of content, which is, you know, it's just nice to look at. Here you got your YouTube search, which you can do. I can pull up my channel over here, and then I'll get, you know, a list of all my videos. So just a real nice looking, you know, good looking application. And you see here, once you click on a vid, it'll load up and you can go to full screen. Ooh, not sure what happened there. You can still go to full screen if you want to, or you can just let the content kind of play over here in its own little panel. But just real, you know, really well done application with the YouTube, the new revised YouTube app. We'll pause that. So definitely holds its own in the multimedia department. Not much to complain about here at all. So let's go ahead and get to the final score and round it out, and we'll see how the Xoom weighs in. So at the end of the day, there's not a whole lot to dislike about the Xoom. I mean, hardware is top notch, it's high grade. You know, 10.1 inch display, dual core processor, tons of RAM, lots of storage, and with the ability to do even more. This will be 4G, you know, compatible within the coming months with the free, you know, hardware upgrade. So for people in the 4G areas, you will get even better performance down the road. And the device just absolutely flies. So there's nothing to really dislike there. Multimedia is very strong. You got a very good media player. Cool little features like the movie, you know, the movie studio where you can chop up and edit your videos and, you know, make them just a little bit nicer before you throw them up on YouTube. That's a big plus. Playing games is another, you know, cool thing. There's some of the usual suspects like Angry Birds and Stupid Zombies. Those play real nicely on here. There's another game preloaded called Air Attack HD, which actually looks, you know, very good. So it's a very good gaming experience and a lot of fun. Web browsing is good. I think it's only going to get better. I think there may be some software tweaks down the road, but I know a lot of people too were knocking off the multimedia experience because it didn't have Flash, but I got lucky enough to get the device a little bit later and Flash actually dropped while the device was in my hands. So, you know, to be able to go to websites, browse, and, you know, play Flash content is a big plus. You know, I think the only knocks on the Xoom would really come in the forms of software. And it's not so much Honeycomb. I like Honeycomb a fair amount. I think they did a pretty good job as far as making their first tablet-specific operating system. And I think, you know, going forward, they got a nice foundation to build upon and things that they can, you know, use and, you know, and just improve on and add, you know, features and just kind of refine it going forward. The biggest knock is the lack of tablet specific apps, and the only, you know, fix for that is going to be time. You got to give the developers time to, you know, get up to speed and, you know, tinker around with this device and see what they're capable of, and then eventually, you know, the apps will start pouring out, but right now, you know, you're definitely not getting the quantity of tablet ready apps like you would for the iPad. The other major knock, I guess, and this isn't really anything to do with the device, it's more with the cost, is the Xoom is an expensive device. Unless you want to go with a two-year contract, you're looking at $799, you know, $800 for this device. If you are willing to go for a two-year data contract, you can get the Xoom for $599, which is, you know, definitely a better price, but still a little bit on the expensive side. So I'm hoping they come in with that Wi-Fi only version and price that around, you know, $499 or $500 even. I think that would definitely be a lot more attractive to people. But it's something you got to weigh in when you've got competitors like the iPad, where you can go and grab a 16 gig iPad, you know, for $500. That, you know, that's something that you have to take a look at. But final score wise, I am giving the Xoom a solid, very solid 8 out of 10. Hardware is, it's a beast. And I mean, performance wise, I don't think you're going to find too many tablets that can match it. Multimedia is very good. I won't quite call it great, but it's a very, very good experience. And I think the software still a little bit, you know, a little bit immature as far as, you know, the app selection. But that's only going to get better with time, and I think that'll just make this device all the more enjoyable. So if you want to check out the full written review, you know the routine, head on over to infamoustechblog.com, and I'll have, you know, the full written notes. I'll post up a couple still photos and pictures to let you guys get a idea for the picture quality. But we'll be back with much more, and hopefully I'll have my hands on an iPad 2 within the next week or two as well, man. So this is Major signing off, y'all. Peace.